Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Scientists on Earth are again being reminded of the awesome power of dust storms on Mars. The first stirrings of what has become a globe-encompassing phenomenon began on June 17th, when a dust storm touched down on the famous Gale Crater. For several decades, such remarkably energetic Martian storms have posed enigmas that meteorologists have yet to resolve. Mars's atmosphere is only slightly more than 0.5% as dense as Earth's. Yet Mars has towering dust tornadoes, some the size of Mount Everest, and global dust storms that dwarf anything ever witnessed on our own planet. In such a tenuous atmosphere, how is dust removed from the soil and accelerated into massive clouds circling the planet up to 40 miles or more above the surface? What holds the dust aloft? What accelerates the winds and dust across the near vacuum of Mars's upper atmosphere to speeds greater than 250 miles per hour? NASA scientists first witnessed such an awesome event in 1971. When Mariner 9 became the first space probe to orbit Mars. In the subsequent nearly half century, mainstream planetary science has shown little progress in deciphering the many mysteries these and many other strange natural events on the red planet present. For many years, the Thunderbolts Project has offered detailed analysis on the role of electricity in our solar system and its connection to planetary, atmospheric, and weather phenomena. This analysis has made many predictions which continue to receive stunning confirmation. To understand the global Martian dust storms, it's first necessary to explore the undeniable electrical nature of another type of dramatic dust-raising event, a Martian dust devil. The so-called dust devils on Mars are truly alien when compared to dust devils on our own planet. These monstrous formations are typically kilometers high and hundreds of meters wide, or approximately 10 times larger than any earthly tornado. The tremendous electric fields associated with the phenomena have been acknowledged by NASA for well over a decade. In 2005, the space agency issued a news release which declared, "When humans visit Mars, they'll have to watch out for towering electrified dust devils." Unfortunately, mainstream planetary scientists can only theorize that the electric fields are ultimately caused by the mechanical energy of air convection. The NASA release states, "Dust devils get their charge from grains of sand and dust rubbing together in the whirlwind when certain pairs of unlike materials rub together. One material gives up some of its electrons, negative charges, to the other material. Smaller dust particles tend to charge negative, taking away electrons from the larger sand grains." And here we see a fundamental confusion of cause and effect. As physicist Wal Thornhill wrote in 2004, "In an electrified universe, charge is already separated on the macroscopic scale, and the movement of air in a dust devil is an effect of charge recombination, not a cause of charge separation." With such low atmospheric pressure, how does one account for the dust particles leaving the surface? For decades, the Electric Universe community has developed experimental research on electrostatic dust transport, which can provide great insights into everything from the collimated jets seen exploding from comets, to the dust storms on Mars and other worlds. In 2001, Thornhill wrote, "When I was doing experiments on electric discharges to a clay surface, there was an electric wind effect that would blow away all of the dust and loose particles from the surface before any arcing took place. When the diffuse discharge is big enough, it will rotate, causing a tornado effect. We have seen but not recognized electric winds on Mars. Mars has no counterpart of thunderclouds to provide a convenient path to ground for electrical differences between the ionosphere and the planet. As a result, more diffuse and very tall discharges must occur, giving rise to an electrical vortex that manifests by the material raised from the surface into the thin atmosphere." In June of 2001, the greatest dust storm ever witnessed on Mars began and did not start to subside for a full 4 months. In 2005, the Thunderbolts.info website published a Picture of the Day article that made two completely unconventional predictions about such dust storms. As noted in the 2007 article, "Martian Dust Devils, Prediction Confirmed." taking a pointer from Wallace Thornhill, we asserted that the global dust storm that engulfed the planet Mars in August and September of 2001 involved a packed assembly of dust devils carrying great volumes of Martian dust into billowing clouds. Since publication of that teapot, a review of dust storm images from the Mars Global Surveyor and from Themis, together with the systematic study of related phenomena on Mars, has confirmed that our statement was accurate. And yet it is also clear that the concept of compact, quote, dust devil congregations could only appear absurd to conventional schools. In standard theory, an atmospheric vortex requires a vastly larger circulation of wind, a condition that precludes what seems clearly to be seen in edge-on pictures of, quote, storm fronts on Mars. This image shows apparent vortices, a word that would not be used by NASA scientists, rising into billowing clouds from the margins of the South Polar ice cap in the Martian summer. The caption accompanying the release reads, "Like billowing smoke from a brush fire, clouds of dust are seen streaming off the edge of the Martian South Polar cap." The same 2005 Thunderbolts article summarized the electrical cause of the massive Martian dust storms as follows. Since Mars has no thunderstorms to, quote, charge up its ionosphere, it should present a good case study of the electric universe. The electrical model predicts that the Martian ionosphere is indeed charged, and it posits no isolated dynamo to, quote, separate charge. On Mars, electrical effects will reach directly from the ionosphere to the surface, without the ameliorating leakage via storm clouds that we see on Earth. Unlike radiant energy from the Sun, electrical energy can accumulate in the planetary capacitor for some time, with the potential for planet-altering events when the atmosphere finally breaks down and massive discharge activity is initiated. At the same time, the electric currents flowing in the Martian ionosphere will drive the high-speed winds in the upper atmosphere. The article then offered a second, extremely radical prediction about global Martian dust storms. It stated, "There is also another aspect to the interplanetary circuitry affecting Mars. The greatest storm on Mars in 2001 occurred when the planet was nearing perihelion and was the closest it had been to Earth in about 12 years. At that time, it was also being, quote, tickled by the Earth's plasma sheath, establishing a temporary electrical connection between Earth and Mars for the transfer of charge. It seems that Mars responded with an outburst of atmospheric discharges, these taking the form of monstrous dust devils, or more accurately, electrical tornadoes. Today, as massive dust storms are again encircling the red planet, science headlines have announced another crucial fact about Mars, though no one outside of the electric universe community appears to have noticed the connection. Just as in 2001, today Mars is again approaching perihelic opposition, and by late July, it will make its closest approach to Earth in 15 years. One such convergence of circumstances could be considered coincidence, but a second instance demands closer examination. Of course, the electric universe also predicts that dramatic solar activity, in the form of coronal mass ejections, can provoke electrical discharges from celestial bodies that move within the Sun's electrical domain, including comets and even planets. Such a display was in fact seen on Mars in recent years, to planetary scientists' complete bafflement. In March of 2012, amateur astronomers spotted enormous plumes jetting from the Martian surface. The plumes were more than 250 kilometers high and several hundreds of kilometers in length. As the lead author of a scientific paper on the discovery stated, "At about 250 kilometers, the division between the atmosphere and outer space is very thin, so the reported plumes are extremely unexpected." In 2016, scientists using data from the Mars Express spacecraft discovered something equally unexpected. Immediately before the plume was first spotted, Mars appeared to be hit by a coronal mass ejection. David Andrews of the Swedish Institute of Space Physics stated, "It's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed. The implications of electrical phenomena are obvious, even to mainstream scientists. A New Scientist report on the discovery stated, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big." It must also be noted that in 2012, just days before scientists noted the baffling plumes, Mars was again at opposition, and at the time was its closest proximity to Earth in over 2 years. As we've noted several times, it's been known for many years that when the Earth's magnetotail passes over the Moon, it causes electrostatic dust storms and visible electrical discharges. As noted by NASA scientist Tim Stubbs, Earth's magnetotail extends well beyond the orbit of the Moon, and once a month, the Moon orbits through it. This can have consequences ranging from lunar dust storms to electrostatic discharges. It is a poignant commentary on institutional science that decade after decade of similar discoveries continue to provoke only surprise and perplexity, yet the surprises are only met with ad hoc amendments to existing theories, rather than the development of promising alternatives. Alternatives which have been waiting for many decades in the fields of plasma physics and electrical engineering. Planets are, quote, organisms that interact with their plasma environments in incredibly dynamic ways. A fact which only confirms that we live in an electrically alive and connected universe.